And so Israel Adesanya obviously was mashing through the middleweight division until his rival Alex Pineda showed up. But as he gets back on the proving ground here tonight, DC, most people believe on any given Saturday night, this is still the best middleweight in the world.
Well, he's proven it time and time again. He has been the man for so long, it would seem hard for him not to operate in that space. But because he believes in himself, because he recognizes who he is, he takes wins and losses as good as anyone I've ever seen. But when it comes down to the X's and the O's, the guy and his fight ability, Israel Adesanya is as good as they come. A phenomenal kickboxer and much improved wrestling that allows for him to stay upright and make guys fight him where he needs him to.
Really seems as though he is getting closer to that mixed martial arts prime, to your point, in terms of putting all the skills together. Israel Adesanya, the last style bender, back in the octagon here tonight. Fill the tape for this heavyweight fight. We send it inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, presenting the former UFC middleweight champion of the world, the All-American Chris Weidman. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, ladies and gentlemen, presenting UFC middleweight champion of the world, Israel the Last Style Bender Adesanya.
Herb Dean is your referee. Ready. He's the third man in the octagon Ready. Tonight.
Good.
All right, so we get another look at Israel Adesanya here tonight. Let's see if he can get off to a fast start. He's not a guy that forces the finish. He will tell you as much that he likes to feel things out a little bit early on. He knows his opponent's going to come shooting at those legs more often than not. Short sample size in the UFC, but Israel Adesanya's takedown defense has held up. All right, too easy right out of the chute. The wrestler is able to land his first takedown attempt against the kickboxer, and hate to overstate it, but that moment feels pretty significant early.
It's a massive moment. He knew that he needed to get this fight to the floor early. He needed to discourage this guy and remind him that, hey, you've defended takedowns before, but you have not defended my takedowns. I am at a different level, and when I am wrestling you, you go down. Armbar attempt. He's got it isolated.
Oh, he's got a strong grip on that arm.
He starts to extend the elbow.
Oh, belly down now. Oh, he got out.
And notice how he got his body all the way across to the opposite side. Now, he's in the on belly, but it's much better than where he was before.
All right, working on the ground here, his opponent's feet on the hips. Oh, nice combination of ground and pound here by White. Nice strike from the bottom fighter there. All right, so he gets back to his feet after that extended battle on the ground, and the crowd is loving it.
The crowd's going
crazy. He's had a huge strike right there. I'm not sure how many more of these his opponent can take.
Massive shot that he landed. Great job.
Good fight here, under two to go. Jab by Adesanya. Oh, stuffs the takedown without issue. Big knee there.
That one landed clean.
Oh!
Oh, he's wobbling now.
And they set it.
Both are tough. Both durable. both unwilling to take a step backward. What a phenomenal fight.
Beautiful hook lands there from Chris Weidman. Same hook, by the way, that he landed against Anderson Silva to become the middleweight champion several years ago. All right, well, good news is he rocked him. Bad news is he wasn't able to finish the job, and now his opponent's back in the fight.
I mean, you don't get those opportunities very often. You got to take full advantage of them when they're presented to you.
Round one winding down here. For the end of round one. All right, there's the end of the round. I'm looking over to my left, UFC President Dana White. I think he's making out the bonus check right now. Incredible back and forth action.
Sign the check, boss. These two young men deserve $50,000. Hell, let's give them each $100,000 for the performance that they just put on in one round. Both were hurt. Both were able to withstand the punishment, and I can't wait until the next round gets started.
Well, I'm not sure the extent to which he has recovered, but we do see the end of the round. DC, talk us through the replay.
Well, he's a tough guy. He's going to make it to the stool. He's going to survive unless you put him completely out of there. Unfortunately, he's in there with a guy that does have that ability.
Oh, nice straight punch there by Adesanya. Just misses with the jab there. Goes for the takedown, he misses. Lands with the lead right. Oh, nice combination there. He is just killing him with volume tonight.
Jab, right hand, body shot, and kicks. What a masterful show of different techniques and ability to throw a combination.
Stuffs the takedown there. How good is his takedown defense? He's in a world of trouble now.
They say the straight moves are the ones that get there first, and it got right to the target. Great job moving into his opponent and getting to that single collar tie.
Takedown defense is there.
Look at the control and the posture as that big knee lands.
Well, he has really picked up the pace here in round two. Much more aggressive than we saw in round one, and now starting to find himself in the pocket. Weidman's looking to pass from full guard into half guard here, but he's denied.
He passed the half guard.
Just over 2 minutes now to go in round two.
He's got to be careful here.
Oh, big elbow. All right, we'll see how he chooses to defend here. Well, as usual, suffocating work from the top here by White. All right, so he lands again, just like we saw in the last round, realizing a lot of success with his Muay Thai game tonight.
You know, why change it? It's working, and it's working from the very start of the fight. The moment this fight started, you saw the advantage that we predicted was there. He started to take advantage of it early, and now he's continuing to build on that. This kickboxer looks amazing tonight.
All right, feet on the hips here. Pretty athletic off his back to avoid that strike from the top.
30 seconds left.
And there you go, again, half guard.
Pretty good work with the ground and pound here by the All-American Weidman.
Another ground and pound strike lands for this man.
All right, round three coming up next. All right, there's the end of the round. So it was a huge strike to the head that stunned his opponent and nearly got him out of there.
Yeah, that was a big moment. A big strike lands, his opponent's on wobbly legs. That is exactly what you want to see as you're walking back to your stool. Your opponent staggering back to his corner and being hopeful that he can get it back together before the start of the next round.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Third round underway. Well, most fighters can't keep up this type of aggression and pace, but you don't have to worry about this guy. He hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight. Huge strike lands there, and somehow his opponent's chin held up.
His opponent's chin held up, but you do not want to be on the receiving end of those types of strikes. Oh, my goodness.
Pretty good jab there by Adesanya.
Good takedown defense by Israel.
Well, as my favorite rap group Onyx would say, stick and move, right? Huh. Beautiful slip off the center line.
Yeah, what a great job. It doesn't take much.
And just misses with that big right hand. He has landed a high volume of strikes in this round and really hasn't let up when it comes to his aggressiveness. The striking has been on point every step of the way. Careful to not gas out, but you gotta like the output here down the stretch. Big right hand. Weidman's nose is bleeding now. Yes, looks as though he got cut by one of those offerings from his opponent. So we have connection like that. I'm not sure his opponent knows where he is.
No, he is on Beat Street right now. He's seeing Tweety Birds over the top of his head. When you take a hook like that, you are on wobbly legs.
Weidman's in half guard. All right, he's got side control here, DC. You know, he's got a lot of different submissions in his arsenal once this fight gets to the ground. A lot of top pressure being applied here.
Yes, smart adjustment, yep.
Trying to pass the guard here, but a nice job by the bottom fighter defensive.
Bottom fighter did a fantastic job of following with his hips, making sure he blocked any attempt to get past his guard.
Nice movement to avoid some of those strikes from the top. Oh, outstanding combination of ground-and-pound punches here by the All-American Weidman. All right, right into side control. Upper body strength figures to be put to good use here.
Yes, absolutely. And you got to look for his opponent to turn back into him. He should chase guillotine, but the opponent turns to the opposite side. He can take his back, throw his hooks in, try to choke, or flatten him out and just go for the finish.
Final seconds of round three. Setting up for another lock now. And there's the horn at the end of the round. How about this fight, folks? You see, he was nearly caught in a submission there right at the end of the round, saved by the bell. So back to the stool, mentally probably not in a great place here. We'll see if he can recover and get himself back into this fight. All right, well, the athletes have kept the replay truck busy tonight. We will take a look back at some of the highlights from that previous round. He opened a cut above his opponent's eye.
And now the cut becomes a story. We are going to have to watch the placement of this cut. Is the blood going to start to leak into the eye? How is he going to be able to fight through the damage that was dealt on those shots? What a great round by his opponent.
Ready.
But now it's on him to make the adjustments that gives himself a chance.
And it's not just the cut man who has his work cut out for him. We'll see if he can make those adjustments and rally here in this next round.
Head kick partially blocked.
Look at that. Quick finish. That was beautiful.
All right, close guard now. Well, pretty good work off of the bottom here by Adesanya. Print the shirts. Ground and pound.
And there you go. Again, half guard. Oh, right into mount.
Really doing a nice job getting these shots home on the ground.
Oh, he's got to be careful there, yep. And another.
Oh, huge elbow.
And how much more can he take? Well, he's got his back now.
He's got that arm triangle. Watch him pass to the opposite side. It looks real tight. He'll drop his weight trying to finish his technique. Knee on belly.
Most fighters will tell you offensive wrestling is the hardest, most exhausting thing.
Especially if you're just running the guy over, John, and then he just gets up.
Ground and pound the hammer, Mark Coleman would be proud. Side control now. Weidman's back to the side control now.
He needs to try to get to a half guard at least. At minimum, try to go to half guard.
All right, so he's got the ground and pound game going here.
Keep going. 1 minute.
Relentless pressure from the top by the All-American Weidman. All right, great position for him here. He's got the full mount. See if he can get that ground and pound going.
Oh, he's got...
setting up an arm lock now. Oh, looks like he's got the sub locked in.
Great job maintaining position over submission. Very smart. Great fight IQ.
All right, he's hanging out inside the closed guard of his opponent here, DC. You got to be careful. All right, so a wild round and a wild sequence there on the ground, DC. Talk us through the highlight.
Yeah, man, you see two high-level grapplers going after it. One guy gets an advantage. The other guy always has a response. We thought it was over. A lesser opponent would have been submitted, but these two are two of the best grapplers in the entire UFC.
Oh, he lands another strike to the body here. Really starting to connect on a lot of strikes to the midsection here in the latter stages of this fight.
Good punch landed. Is going to be over. I can't believe he's still standing. That shot landed perfect.
Timely defense there. Huge block for him. Weidman's blocking well now. You see the fighter raise the guard to protect that obviously damaged nose.
Beautiful high kick there.
Could be the beginning of the end here. So holding on to him here, not doing a ton, perhaps just looking to recover. 1-2 there by Weidman. All right, late in the fight now, DC. The submission specialist clearly is going to be on the wrong end of the scorecards if we get
them. You got to get going. It does not matter if you get reversed from the top. It does not matter if you get the guard pass. You got to just start throwing up submissions and hope by causing action, you can latch onto something to end the fight.
Oh, he's landed a high number of total strikes here in the latter stages of this fight. He's really picked up the pace and landing far more strikes than he did in previous rounds.
Don't set up that overhand.
All right, so now huge shot, finds the target there.
Great shot lands. Now he's got to go find that follow-up attempt.
Just a relentless effort out of this fighter here tonight. The ref had no choice but to step in, and that is how you leave the judges out of it. We send it inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 46 seconds of round number 5. Declaring the winner by TKO, Israel the Last Style Bender, Adesanya.
All right, so Israel Adesanya, your winner by TKO. A lot of people didn't give him a chance to put this dude away. Put him away, all right.
He was confident that he can get the job done. He thought that he could finish his fight, and that's exactly what he did.